Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video. In this video, which we are doing a bit of a setup for, we are going to test out the sync bin function inside of DaVinci Resolve 16 beta version 2. I did a video not long ago about the first beta version, but now I want to do a video about the sync bin and how to use that to do multicam editing. And in this video, especially if you do not have a timecode selected. So I am shooting on three cameras. I'm shooting here on the Ursa Mini Pro right here. Up here, I have the Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. And here I have the old classic production camera 4K. And I figured we would just throw this into the edit and try to make it work. And in this case, see if it's possible to make a multicam edit using only the sound function where it actually syncs to the sound. So again, for the sound bit of this, on the Ursa Mini, I have a lavalier mic, which is the Rode Wireless Go connected, and this is making the audio. On the Pocket, it's just the built-in microphone, as well as on the production camera. Same kind of thing. So let's see how this will work inside of DaVinci Resolve beta version 2. And also we are going to test the new close-up function, which are in the beta version 2. It is the ability to make DaVinci Resolve make your a close-up out of one of the shot, for instance, a wide shot, which will be from the Ursa here, and to make it look like a close-up like this. But we're going to see all about that in the video right now. So let's go into DaVinci Resolve 16 beta version 2. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve 16.1 beta 2, and we're going to have a look at how to do this multicam thing. So let's just have a look at that. So let's, the first thing is we have a multicam clip here, three clips, but there's one thing we need to do before we actually continue. Let's go back to the master bin. First off, we are just going to do a new timeline. We're going to call that multi. Okay, and we are just going to create that. So now we have a timeline down here. Second thing we need to do is we need to go back to the media here and go into our multi-clip. And we have three clips here. The first clip I have here is from the Ursa. And I need to set this up in the right way. So if I go into the metadata, I can go in under the shot and scene. And in this case, I want this to be my A-cam, and it's already per default the A-cam. If I then go to the second camera, you will see this is also a cam, and I don't want that to be that. That is the pocket camera. So I'm going to make this as my B cam. Like that. And then I'll just go to the third camera, which is the cinema production camera 4K. And this is what that clip is called. And I don't really want it to be called that. So I'll call this camera C, A, B, and C. So with that out of the way, I'll go back to the cut page. Then here I have my clips, and then I'm just going to highlight those clips, and I'm going to press this icon we have here. And what this is going to do, this is the way we're going to sync our clip. And as you see right now, it is absolutely out of sync and not usable at all. So we have different ways of syncing the clips, either by putting in a out point or in point. And let's just face it that most of us are not going to use timecode because we do not have a timecode generator, and that is a expensive thing. And also not all cameras are supporting timecode anyway. So the method we are going to use is we're going to use audio. So we're going to select the audio and simply just hit the sync. So here we are. It should be synced. The cameras were not started at the same time as you can see here. So let's see. I did do a sync clip. I think they are in sync. It's just a little. There we are. I think we're pretty much in sync. So what we then want to do now is we just are going to save our sync. And when we save our sync, we actually have these icons appearing up here would just mean that these clips are synced together and are ready to go. And I'm just going to take these three clips, I'm going to drag those down to the timeline, and then I'm going to move a bit in time. Just a little bit, something where... Okay, I have a sync clip here. Okay, let's say we are beginning from here. And then I'm just going to drag that. Okay, and then I'm just going to hit the sync bin. So now all three cameras should be more or less aligned. And now we can just start to edit. So let's begin here.
Okay, I'll do a sync clap. And we'll try to do this. Whoa, with all these cameras.
So in this case, we want to start with me saying hello here. So let's do that.
Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to a...
And for instance, if we want to go to cut number two, we'll just put push two here. And then we can just, again, put this all place on top here, and we'll just click like that, and it's there.
Another video here at the channel. This is a bit of a different video. As you see, I am in
And then we see I'm doing a turn here with my face, and then I over my head. And then let's go to, we can then go a couple of frames back. So let's say we're going to cut to three here, and we're going to add that down.
So I'm in my living room trying so to make this video. So hopefully this will be just good enough. It's a bit of a bad sound in here.
Okay, so this is the basic of doing this multicam, and it's pretty easy and intuitive. And let's say you wanted to use the new feature again, which is the close-up feature. So with this clip selected, which is like the A-cam, we are going to make a close-up. And just by clicking here, we're going to make a close-up. And of course, we can't really see what it's doing because it's showing the same clip here. But if we go back here to the timeline view, we have
sound in here, but nevertheless. So what other...
And then, again, this is a work in progress in DaVinci Resolve. It is the neural engine that's trying to figure out how to frame this shot the best way, and then try to center the shot. And if you don't like what the neural engine has done, you can just click the three buttons here. And then let's say we want to move this shot a bit down, something like that. Small little correction.
Sound in here, but nevertheless. So what other reason for this setup I'm having?
So again, a super simple way of doing that. So anyway, this is a super simple way of making a multicam edit using the waveform to line up the cameras. So now, by the way, what we can do as well, let's see, we have three cameras on, right? Okay, so what we can do here, we have our cameras here, and let's say we do not want to use the audio from camera from camera one or camera two, because they're just going to be on track two. So I'm just going to mute the track, and then I'm only going to use the track from the Rode Wireless Go.
A bit of a different video. As you see, I am in my living room trying so to make this video. So hopefully this will be just...
So as you see, this is working just super fine, actually. It is a super easy way of making a multicam. So I know this is a super quick and easy example to how to set this up. I want to test this further again coming up in some other videos where I try to throw in some GoPros and stuff like that. But just for like the basic, this is working just fine. And it will just be, you'll do your edits here, and then you'll go to the edit page if you want to do some small corrections, and then you'll just make the shots match. And that is basically how the sync bin works in DaVinci Resolve 16.1 beta 2. Anyway, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.